years of, you know, tackling all sorts of different challenges and, you know, fighting through all the things that life has put in front of you, you've gotten all this great experience now, and you're at a point in your life where that knowledge can be shared, and that's kind of the first thing you said, is that you'd like to share that with others. What advice would you give to that group of youth that is out there today, and they do have dreams like you of you know, playing college sports or going on to the professional level, and they need that little push. You know, what in your life could you share with them and give to them that little bit of extra oomph that they might need to kind of push themselves to that next level?
I guess three things I think that matter most is one is having something that you want to do. You know, that you said maybe they have that, and I hope they do, but something my mom had always told me, you know, stand for something or you'll fall for anything. So you got to have something that you want to pursue. Now, it doesn't have to be for the rest of your life, but you got to have something that you're gonna have that's gonna allow you to say no to all the bad things in life and all the distractions. So find your passion, right? In the passion for now, you commit to something now. You'll learn the skill of commitment. Things can change in the future, but you're gonna understand what it means to actually do something. Go all in with what we chose, whether it's football or music. It doesn't even matter. So have your passion, find something, or else you're going to get pushed and pulled all through life by what everyone else wants you to do. So pick what you want to do and learn that skill of actually making a choice. Two, I think, is who are you surrounding yourself with? This is a choice. Now, your parents are your parents, and I hope they're good people. And sometimes your teachers are your teachers. But really, most of the people that you surround yourself with for your days is going to be within your control. And you got to decide right now, are these people that are going to support what you're doing, help what you're doing, and challenge you what you're doing, and keep and hold you accountable to what you say you want to do? Or are these people that are going to pull you away from it, not support you, laugh at you for that, and think it's silly? Because I think we all know, show me your friends and I'll show you your future. So, you know, be very careful with who you select, and pick people. They don't have to be on the same mission with you, but that helps if they are. And have some people like that, but they need to support what you're doing, hold you accountable to it, and be there to encourage and keep you on the right path. And that's very powerful. I think the most important thing you can do is pick the people that you spend your time with, because you will become more like them. And so are these people that you want to be more like, and they want you to be who you want to be or not? Very careful with who you spend your time with. And I think the final thing is you got to build a mindset, and this is where your friends will help you. You got to build a mindset where you look for opportunities and not excuses. And so every single moment of your life, your day will give you an opportunity to have an excuse. And sometimes they're great. And sometimes they're ones that no one would ever question. And they'll give you the opportunity to quit working for what you want. Or you can look at that situation in life that's going to give you a chance to have an excuse, and you look at it as an opportunity to get better and grow. If you take that mindset on, you become unstoppable, because I think we all see the great people in life are not the ones that are given the most talent. They're the ones that refuse to quit and won't accept excuses as reasons not to do things. They look for answers. They don't look for outs. They look for ins. And they look for ways to keep going in. And so that's framed with having something that matters enough to you. Because if something doesn't matter enough to you, then it's easy to go to excuses. You have to have something that matters enough to you. You have to surround yourself with people that, one, know what matters to you, and two, will support you, challenge you, hold you accountable to that, and three, everything that hits you in life, you have to look at as an opportunity to improve so you keep moving forward, instead of an opportunity to quit, take it easy, whine, complain, and blame. That's not going to get you anywhere. The beautiful thing about those three things, John, they require zero talent. They're available to anybody at any age group, anytime, and I believe all three of those things are transferable through the rest of your life. So amateur sports, I think, is the greatest place to learn this stuff. You pick a hike, you pick a sport, you pick an activity, you surround yourself with friends that are going to push, encourage, and hold you accountable. And every day when you pursue it, you're going to have an opportunity why you'll fail, why you should quit, why you should get out of it, why it's not going to work. And you need to look at that as what you need to do to get better. I think if you do those kind of things, maybe you succeed in your actual goal, maybe you don't, but either way, you'll become as good as you possibly can at that event. That's winning, and that will build those skill sets that I think will last a lifetime, far beyond your bench press numbers, far beyond your 40 speed, far beyond the touchdowns, far beyond the cool sneakers you like to wear. You'll become someone that understands how to make a choice in life, how to be responsible for who you surround yourself with, and how to look adversity in the eye and find answers and not excuses.
Angus, I love it. That was a great answer. That's the kind of thing that kids need to hear today. They need that message, and that's fantastic. That was a wonderful 3 points that I think kids can really hang their hat on and learn from. So thank you. That was fantastic.